So, the Manfrotto 290 Xtra series aluminum legs paired with the 128RC fluid head. Or as Manfrotto also calls it, well, hold on. The MK290 XTA3-2WUS tripod. I think I'll just go with the former there. So I previously did a video on the Manfrotto compact action tripod, where I talked about the fact towards the end that I had moved on to another model. And this was mainly for a few reasons. Number one, I simply needed a tripod that could hold a larger payload in terms of the cameras and lenses that I was now using. Number two, the fact that I needed a fluid head that could support smooth pans and tilts with my camera and those sorts of movements. And number three, I just needed something that was a little more stable that I could use as kind of an all-around workhorse tripod going forward. Now I came upon this tripod probably a little over a year ago and decided to make the purchase and just give it a good run through with a lot of gigs I was doing at the time. Now to talk through the specs of the tripod briefly, this tripod has aluminum legs, which although weighing a bit more than the carbon fiber variants they also make for this, provide a really stable and solid base for this overall tripod system. The legs themselves come with flip locks, which make the tripod really easy to adjust. They also allow for sort of a, I believe, 3 or 4 way positioning in terms of how low you can adjust the legs and spread them out. So you can really get this tripod fairly low to the ground and angle it in a lot of different ways that with some other tripod systems, they simply wouldn't allow. Now overall, the legs I believe weigh 3.9 pounds and the legs support up to 11 pounds of a payload. However, the 128RC head, when you add that to the legs, weighs in total at around 5.6 pounds and the head itself supports up to 8.8 pounds. So 8.8 to 11 pounds in terms of a max payload. I think if your camera is towards the bottom of that range, it'll certainly be able to support it. Now overall, this tripod has as low of a height as 15.9 inches and can extend with its center post all the way up to about 67.5 inches or so. Now the 128RC head itself has, as I mentioned before, a nice fluid pan and tilt design with separate independent knobs that you can adjust for each of these. It also is paired with the 200PL plate system, which I really like from Manfrotto. So this makes it very easy to adapt your camera onto multiple different Manfrotto heads, whether that's for tripods or monopods or anything else. For the most part, a lot of tripod systems that are on the higher end can easily run you into the hundreds, if not more, if you're looking at something like a Sackler system. But really what I wanted was a system that could easily support just about any DSLR or mirrorless body and any lens I could throw at it and would handle itself very well for all types of different gigs. Now what I can say is after using this for over a year, this tripod has certainly delivered in that case. This has really become my go-to for a lot of weddings and different things. I also just filmed a kid's sort of rock school concert where I used a couple of these to get some static angles for the stage. Worth noting that one of these was in direct line of subwoofers too, and a fair amount of bass rumble just in the building and the floor in general. So I was pretty impressed with how this held up in that regard as well. And maybe a few other points to talk about with this tripod. It does come with its own little carrying bag, which it's kind of just enough to protect it, I would say, if you pair it in a larger case with a bunch of other tripods and gear. But more importantly, would be certainly sufficient for being able to sling over your shoulder to walk into a venue with. You'll notice when you get this tripod that you will see a little kind of separate plastic tool that sits on one of the legs. Pretty much as soon as you find this, my recommendation is just to take this off and put it somewhere safe where you won't lose it. This is actually the tool that Manfrotto provides to use with tightening the different screws on the legs. Generally, you'll find you might need this in time to sort of shore the tripod up as you use it more, but if you don't separate this piece out, it'll likely fall off your legs within 1 or 2 uses, and then you won't know where it is and how to find it when you actually need it. The other thing I'll note with this tripod is that to adjust and kind of more permanently lock on the tripod head, you'll need to locate a very sort of oddly placed screw that is generally difficult to get to. And what you might find is if you don't tighten this down, or with the way this generally comes from the factory out of the box, panning left will cause the tripod head to get a little bit loose. You could probably just find the screw, tighten it down, and you're set, or carry a screwdriver with you and prepare to be slightly frustrated every time you intend to adjust this. So while I've sort of talked about the tripod up to this point, would I recommend it? In short, yes. This is actually a really good tripod that I've been very pleased with. I'm actually recording with it right now as I'm talking to you. I own 2 of them currently, and it remains pretty likely that I'm going to pick up possibly a third or even more as my cameras and kit grows. And I know that this is solid enough of a workhorse that I can continue to purchase these for not too much money and use them and get a lot of mileage out of them with these cameras and these types of setups that I'm using. And I would say if you're a video shooter that does a lot of types of different work with DSLR and mirrorless cameras, as I am myself, this is a really solid option to consider. So that's my review on the Manfrotto 290 Xtra and 128RC tripod and tripod head. Now hopefully this review has been of some help to you. Feel free to leave a like and subscribe if it has. I'm definitely planning on doing more gear reviews as time goes on with this channel. That is all I have to say. So thanks for watching.